திரு குரு டி டி ரங்கராஜன்.
Thoughts brought to you by Bharat Matrimony.
There's something very essential that we need to understand about our own mental engineering. There's this conscious mind and there is this subconscious mind. The subconscious mind does not understand positive emotions and negative emotions. It only understands deep emotions and shallow emotions. And the way the subconscious mind is engineered is, wherever it perceives deep emotions, it believes that is what you want more and more of in your life. That's the recurrence that you are seeking. Let me give you an example and explain. You have a beautiful relationship that's going on in your life right now and you love this relationship a lot. But your love is a very shallow love. But you have been hurt by a relationship that has left you in life. And the hurt that somebody had betrayed you in life and gone is so deep in you that you all the time keep going through this remorse that you have been forsaken by somebody in life, you have been betrayed by somebody in life, and the hurt of losing that relationship is very deep in you. What you're not realizing is, by experiencing the depth of hurt of losing a relationship and feeling shallow about a relationship that you love, without your knowledge, you're programming your subconscious to believe that you enjoy losing a relationship. Because it doesn't understand positive emotions and negative emotions. It only understands deep emotions and shallow emotions. So often you find as a result, it's only a question of time that one more time you find yourself losing another relationship and then another relationship. Let me caution you, if there is a pattern to suffering in your life, that's because there is a pattern to your thought patterns. And unless you change your thought patterns, you are not going to bail yourself out of the pattern of suffering you go through in life. Classic example I can give for this is, whenever new people are recruited in an organization, there is not much hangama about it. Okay, new people have joined. At best, there is an induction program which is very formal. But whenever an employee resigns from an organization, there's a lot of deep hurt in the organization. There's a lot of gossip in the organization. A resignation is made into a very big event in the organization. And collectively, what we are not realizing is, we are programming the subconscious of the entire organization, especially the head of the organization who regrets losing an employee so much. Because you regret the loss of this employee with so deep, your subconscious believes you enjoy losing people a lot more than new people joining you. In all those organizations where recruitment is a shallow experience and resignation is a celebrated event, you'll find there is more and more attrition in the organization because your subconscious continues to conspire against you to ensure more and more people keep leaving because it believes that to which you associate deep emotions is what you want more and more of in life. Another classic example I can give a lot of you is, those of you who don't talk about your health, but you brag about your sickness. Even a simple headache, somebody asks you, how is your headache? You will keep talking till the other one gets headache. You brag about it. A simple injury, and too much is discussed about a simple injury. But somehow when you're healthy, you don't even think it's necessary to talk about it. What you have done is, you have programmed your subconscious to believe sickness, injury is what you prefer a lot more than a fit body. And these are the people where you will always find, even where you go to learn yoga, you suffer an injury and come back. You will go to a fitness studio and there something will go wrong. That's because you have, without your knowledge, programmed your subconscious to believe that injuries and sickness matters lot more to you than you being healthy and fit. So I want to bring to your notice, unless we train ourselves one more time, unless we train ourselves from the beginning to ensure our positive emotions are deep and our negative emotions are shallow, we will not be able to bring about a major turnaround in our life, no matter how many speeches you listen to, how many books you read, and how many scriptures, discourses you go through. So the shift that I'm expecting from all of us is this. One, anything negative, speak in one sentence. Anything positive, speak in five sentences. You want to speak about your health? Speak in five sentences. You want to speak about your sickness? Just leave it as a passing remark. You want to share with people that a new team has joined your organization? Speak about it in five sentences. You want to talk about resignation? Speak in a single sentence. Anything positive, speak in five sentences. Anything negative, either don't speak about it, or if you must, keep it to a single sentence. Two, it is very important to realize anything negative, intellectually analyze it. Don't get emotionally involved. Anything positive, ensure there is emotional involvement. Anything positive, which means resignation of an employee is intellectually analyzed. Conduct an exit interview, learn what you must learn, make the corrections in the system of the organization, move on. But a set of new people are recruited into the organization, the induction program must be a celebration. You've lost the race, sit with your coach, intellectually analyze where you faltered, where you need to retrain, where you need to correct and move on. If you have won the race, run the victory lap. Get emotionally involved. Always run the victory lap. There is a failure, a major account has been lost. Let the board sit together, intellectually analyze why you lost that account. Make the corrections and move on. If you have got a new account, there must be celebration in the organization. Success must be celebrated. Anything negative, intellectually analyze. Anything positive, emotionally get involved. And three, and most important, the third point, train yourself to experience deep positive emotions and keep your negative emotions shallow. You have to learn to experience the depth of love. No point in keeping love shallow. Practice enough touch in those relationships. Make your love visible. Be demonstrative about your love to your loved ones. Need be, keep writing to them. Use small notes of expressions of love. Deepen your expressions of love. You're happy. Learn to deepen your happiness. Learn to laugh. Learn to dance. Learn to celebrate. Create a context by which you get enough people to participate in deepening your happiness. Every success, gift yourself something, gift others, create a treat, create a festivity around to celebrate that success. As an individual, as a family, as an organization, as a society. In fact, all of you should realize the very purpose of festivity, and in India everything is a festival. The very culture tells you anything good, there must be deep positive emotions associated to it. The moment you bring about these three changes into your lifestyle, one, anything negative, one sentence. Anything positive, five sentences. Anything negative, intellectually analyze it. Anything positive, get emotionally involved. Three, train yourself into deep positive emotions. So what is important here is, sometimes there will be negative happenings in your today in your life that is because of the deep negative emotions you associated yesterday. So even when something is negative today, you have to find a way by which you positively respond to it today, and this will be the programming of tomorrow. Your yesterday's emotional reactions has become the script of your today. Your today's positive emotional responses will become the script of your tomorrow. By getting these three aspects right, you will get your subconscious programming right. And by getting your subconscious programming right, you will get the tomorrows of your life right. And by getting the tomorrows of your life right, you will get your life right. I love you so much. Thank you. There's something very essential that we need to understand about our own mental engineering. There's this conscious mind and there is this subconscious mind. The subconscious mind does not understand positive emotions and negative emotions. It only understands deep emotions and shallow emotions. And the way the subconscious mind is engineered is, wherever it perceives deep emotions, it believes that is what you want more and more of in your life. That's the recurrence that you are seeking. So I want to bring to your notice, unless we train ourselves one more time, unless we train ourselves from the beginning to ensure our positive emotions are deep and our negative emotions are shallow, we will not be able to bring about a major turnaround in our life, no matter how many speeches you listen to, how many books you read, and how many scriptures, discourses you go through. So the shift that I'm expecting from all of us is this. One, anything negative, speak in one sentence. Anything positive, speak in five sentences. You want to speak about your health? Speak in five sentences. You want to speak about your sickness? Just leave it as a passing remark. Two, it is very important to realize anything negative, intellectually analyze it. Don't get emotionally involved. Anything positive, ensure there is emotional involvement. And three, and most important, the third point, train yourself to experience deep positive emotions and keep your negative emotions shallow.